Hello again to the Blue Generation MOOC. In this video, we will explain in more detail the blue economy sector called shipbuilding and repair. I will describe its meaning and scope in Europe and the possibilities it has to offer training and employment. What do we mean by shipbuilding and repair? In this MOOC, we will include the following: the building of ships and floating structures, the repair and maintenance and the manufacturing of marine equipment and marine machinery. Although closely related, we will include the building of pleasure boats into coastal tourism. Let us look at some general facts and figures about this sector. The shipbuilding and repair sector in Europe directly employs about 315,000 people, and it generated a trading value of 14.8 billion euros and a profit of 3.6 billion euros. This corresponded to 8% of the jobs and 5% of the profits for the total blue economy. In terms of employment, this sector, Germany leads with 16% of the total jobs, followed by France and then Italy. The average wage was about 37,000 euros. According to the European Commission, the number of persons employed in the supply chain to this sector are as much as those employed in shipbuilding itself. The EU is a major player in the global shipbuilding industry with over 300 large shipyards. European companies specialise in different segments of the shipbuilding sector and are leading in the construction of cruise ships, support vessels, fishing vessels, ferries, research ships and super yachts. These projects are characterised by a high level of technological and high trading value. This specialisation and lead position is a direct result of the sector's continuous investment into research and innovation, as well as the employment of a very highly skilled workforce. Now, let us look at shipbuilding and repair separately. Regarding the building of ships, approximately 120,000 people are directly employed in this subsector. Germany is the top employer, followed by Italy. The construction business is expanding and currently generates over 7.8 billion euros in trade value. Profits from this activity are estimated at about 990 million, and these profits have almost doubled in the last 10 years. The repair and maintenance business is also growing and generates over 3.3 billion euros in trade each year. Again, Germany, France and Italy are the main players for this industry. So what jobs are there? There are many different opportunities in this sector, as it's a complex industry that requires many professionals working in different positions with different skills and training levels. Regarding the construction of ships, the industry requires architects to design the ships, the parts, the structures, and the materials. Also, there is a demand for highly qualified specialists in technology, IT services, insurance, economics and logistics. There are also many different skilled professionals needed without higher education qualifications to carry out the tasks of construction, manufacturing of equipment, logistics and distribution. The demand for high quality design and construction for the various materials used in the shipbuilding is huge. Therefore, structural engineers, civil engineers, or industrial engineers are constantly sought after. Many colleges and universities around the EU offer bachelor degrees for these qualifications. There is a range of maritime engineering bachelors, such as maritime and nautical engineering, with various specializations. Many other university degrees can be used in this sector, from economics to informatics law or design. There are many highly skilled craftsmen and women required for shipbuilding, and currently there is a very high demand for people. Many vet training centres, academies and schools offer courses and training for these professions, which include, for example, welders, painters, carpenters, plumbers and electricians. There are also very specific skills required within these environments, which may require further specialist training. This training is usually provided by the employers and can allow further progress in one's chosen career. More recently, the industry faces two challenges. On the one side, there is the lack of much needed science and engineering students entering the sector. And on the other side, the workforce in the industry is aging and approaching retirement age. This has led shipyards to run different campaigns to engage young workers and offer a range of on-the-job training possibilities, such as dual vet training schemes. An interesting development in German shipbuilding is the development of a dual system of studies combining a vocational education with a bachelor degree for applied sciences. In 4 to 5 years' time, the students employed by the shipyards follow their course of studies in combination with the practical training phases on shipyards. As a result, they can obtain a double qualification as the skilled worker and Bachelor of Science. What is the outlook? The shipbuilding sector provides the vessels for several blue economy activities. These vessels are needed for fishing and maritime transport, marine, mineral, oil and gas extraction, offshore renewable energy activities, aquaculture and coastal tourism. This sector faces fierce and increasing international competition from countries like China and South Korea, which has led to the European Union to enter niche markets of specialized high-tech ships, and thus the need for highly skilled, educated and motivated young people. And there are many new opportunities for the EU shipbuilding and equipment sectors, especially in emerging sectors such as assistance vessels for offshore structures used in marine renewable energy activities. Young people for jobs in this sector are in high demand and can expect interesting, rewarding employment opportunities.